The weir was a decommissioned Environment Agency gauging structure, which was used to measure water levels previously. So they help obviously gain an understanding of flooding and river levels in storms and things like that. And it does provide a barrier to fish passage. Adult fish struggle to get up the river to their spawning sites. They need to free passage really to the good areas to lay their eggs. And young fish get damaged when they're then traveling back down the air to get out to sea or to find new territories. So it's not just the big migratory fish like salmon and trout that it affects. It affects all ranges of fish. They segregate populations such as trout and minnows, bullheads. All of them have issues that are caused by artificial barriers in the river. This project is part of a wider range of similar projects across Cumbria. It makes up part of the Cumbrian River Restoration Strategy, where we look at restoring the natural processes of rivers, taking out barriers, putting back meanders and the variety of habitats. And that has benefits not just for wildlife, but also for managing flood risk and just generally improving the areas that we live in and the rivers that we live by. So this particular project is being funded by the Environment Agency, who are the lead partner on the project, and it's being funded through the Water Environment Improvement Fund. We're working with Ebbsford Environmental, who are very well experienced at projects like this, at removing weirs and restoring rivers.
We're going to take a sensitive approach with this, like we do all of our schemes, and there'll be sediment entrapment mats installed downstream for the duration of the works. Several options have been appraised over the past few years, and cutting of the metal plate, lifting it out, has been deemed the most cost-effective and safe way to allow fish passage once again. The strategy is to take it out in smaller sections, which will be unbolted, cut away and then lifted out of a small excavator on the bank. The concrete will be peckered out. We're going to do a 2 metre strip in the middle, which will naturally allow itself to widen over time as stones come down the stream.